I am so agitated right now. I swear I was losing my fucking mind while working today. It is currently 6:16 in the morning, and I got off work at 5:20 in the morning. I was supposed to leave at 5, but my manager kept having me do things, and I was getting so frustrated because I just wanted to go home because it's my day off now. So, yeah. And I was gonna do these videos for you guys yesterday, but I slept most of the day and I had no energy. I was really tired for some reason. I have no idea why. Well, I kind of do. But, I was still tired and I slept until like 4 or 5. Anyways, welcome to video one of my Valentine's Day special, or as I like to call it now, my late Valentine's Day special. And pretty much, as I've said in my collection videos, this year it pretty much most likely will be my final year doing YouTube videos. Now, that's not to say like it's going to be my final year, because I am thinking about starting a new YouTube channel and focus on something different. But for right now, for like on this channel, it might be my final year, so it's still all up in the air right now. But because of that, I want to focus this year, at least for how long I plan on staying on this channel, to basically let you guys get to know more about me. Because for as long as I've started YouTube, since 2011, I believe, on January 18th, you guys, I haven't really made videos for you guys to get to know more about me. I mean, I've made some videos, I made some vlogs, showing like what's gone on in my life throughout the years. Those sort of stopped because, I didn't really go out much. I mostly went out with my fiance, who was my girlfriend at the time, and we just did a lot of things, and that was worthy of recording. Where, since she moved, there's not much to record about. You get what I'm saying? So the vlogs pretty much sort of halted. Some vlogs have popped up recently, but it's just not much, And so you guys didn't really get to know, I didn't really get to release videos that let you guys get to know more about me, and pretty much that's what these videos are going to be about right now. And as the video is titled, How Did I Meet Her? Is basically referring to my fiance, who at the time was just somebody that I had feelings for, that eventually turned into my girlfriend and then turned into my fiance. Her name is Stacy. I'm not going to say her last name or her middle name, but her name is Stacy. And I wanted to tell you guys exactly how me and her got together. And, that's also why I'm dressed up all nice. I got all dressed up for you guys after work because I love you. And, well, I feel like just wearing my polo green shirt just wouldn't fit well for, the kind of videos I'm planning to do for you guys. So, with that being said, let's begin with the story. So, the first time I remember, like, if I think back on how far back was the first time I ever saw her, was I went to a play at my high school. And I don't remember what the play was about. It was like a random play, I think. It was like a friend of mine was actually in it too. Actually, a couple of my friends were in it, so I was basically there to support them as well as some other friends that were in the crowd. And it was like this really random play where one of my good friends, who I don't talk to much now, but I still consider him a good friend, he basically, it was like auditions. He and two other people were judges, and everyone else was trying to audition. It was a pretty funny play, I will say. They were pretty good. And I gotta say, this guy, the friend I'm talking about, I swear, every time I watch any clips of Will Ferrell, the first thing that pops in my head is the friend. He's like a young version of Will Ferrell. He's a pretty funny guy. Crazy. And recently he released a photo of him dressed up as a, well, not dressed up as a woman, but he had the wig, lipstick, eyeliner. It was kind of weird. Especially when I thought he was one of a like a cosplayer I follow on Facebook. It was really weird. Anyways, I'm getting kind of off topic. But basically that was what the play was. And the first time I saw her, she had a very small minor role, and you guys might laugh at this, but I'm sitting in the crowd and I see her go up, and I still remember what she wore that day, which was a white and black striped shirt or sweater, I don't remember. And she also had a skirt on, I think. God, I'm getting so old. I don't remember, but I definitely know this that was the shirt, I think. God, I don't know if it's me being tired or I'm just getting old, but either way, I'm just gonna stick with that. It was that and a skirt. And the first thing I thought was, she's pretty cute. Because she has a nice butt too. I mean, all I saw was pretty much her backside. But I definitely remember that was what I was thinking, was she had a nice butt. And she does. And she might kill me for saying that on camera, but I'm being honest with you guys. That was the first thing I actually thought. When I first saw her, I was like, she has a nice butt. And I just want to tell you guys too, I personally was at that point where I was kind of giving up on relationships. I didn't really care. And I just want to tell you guys too, I sort of had girlfriends in the past. There was this one girl, her name was Sue, and it was only for a day. And it was pretty much not really going out. We spent one day together during school, and then she broke it off because she felt like it was not right, or it was some bullshit. I honestly felt like she was using me. Then she did it again, never saw each other for that one day, broke it off. But she said it might have been for the guilt that, like, I don't remember exactly. It was something about her mother, because her mother was in the hospital, I think. But yeah, I don't really count that. So yeah, no, just no. Anyways, yeah, I've never really had any luck with women. So at that point in time, I was starting to give up. I didn't really care who I was hitting on. Well, then again, I personally didn't never even realize who I like when I was hitting on somebody. But like I just didn't care who I flirted with or not. I was just doing me, pretty much. And here comes Stacy. Like, I'm just looking at her like, she's cute, but I just don't think anything's gonna happen. And I really didn't think anything was gonna happen. She says one time that after, I think it was after that moment, she hugged me from behind when I had a brown leather jacket on, and I'm actually looking at it right now. And basically, she was the one who was falling for me first. And I God, I don't really. I'm sorry. I'm so tired right now, and I want to get these videos out for you guys. But she was definitely the one who fell for me first. And while I did like her at the time, I didn't really pursue it because I didn't think anything would happen. I really thought I had no chance at all. I didn't think I had any chance with any woman. So during the summer, she was up north. At the time, she went up north a lot for the summer because, that's where their second home is. And basically, me and her started talking online. At the time, it was MySpace, and that's when we got to know each other a lot more. We pretty much connected through Resident Evil. We connected through our dogs. Rest in peace, Brandy. Love you, girl. Kind of laughed at that. We basically connected a lot. We basically found out we were both gamers. We're basically both nerds, and we found out a lot more about each other. And then she found out, I dropped out of school. She was sad because she didn't see me the first day of school, because, she didn't. I think I did tell her, but I think she forgets. She tends to forget a lot of things I tell her involving that kind of stuff. But no, I don't think I told her. Yeah, I don't think I told her. But yeah, she was pretty sad about it. And for the longest time, I was nervous to even ask her out or go out with her, because she definitely wanted to go out. She definitely wanted to go out, or at least wanted to see me, like have me walk to school. Because at right now, my high school is, well, my old high school is about a 20-minute walk, so I could walk back and forth. And I did that a lot when we started going out. I went there every single day. But I was just so nervous, and I just made up excuses because I was like, I just don't want to get hurt again. Because Sue, I liked a lot. Personally, I say to myself, I loved her. She was basically the first actual love of my life, and now she's just a friend. But, I really cared about Sue, and her doing that to me hurt me a lot, to the point where I was just like, I don't want to get hurt like that again. And to be honest, some other things have happened in my life where it kind of scared me off from ever wanting to ask a girl out. So, are you fucking kidding me? Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Okay, he's good. Anyways, where was I? I need a drink. That's so good. That's gonna wake me up a little bit. Anyways, but yeah, I was just so scared that. Anyways. I was I sw Uno momento, por favor. I'm trying to record, kitty cat. Now, back off. Right. So, where was I? Anyways, yeah, I was just really, really nervous about asking her out, so I tried to make any excuse to not see her because, like I said, I just didn't want to get hurt. So eventually, a friend of ours, a mutual friend named Robin, she set up this hangout thing where we went to go see a movie, which I actually have that movie. Come here, movie. My back hurts. I'm old. Ooh. Ooh. Anyways, yeah, basically she set up this hangout thing with two or three other friends, and she knew that me and Stacy liked each other, but we never really went for it. So we basically both agreed to do it. And God, I still remember the first time that she just came out of her mother's van with Robin, and I was so fucking nervous. Like, she looked really pretty, and I was just, I don't think I talked that much. I really don't think I talked that much. So the movie was Surrogates. I bought this specifically just because, it was the first movie we went to go see. I liked it. It was all right. But yeah, we went to go see it, and we flirted a lot during that movie. And just to say, we didn't kiss. And basically, we were just like holding hands, just playing with each other's hands. It was just a very flirtatious moment for us. We watched the movie, of course, we paid attention, but we were definitely flirting a lot with each other. I might have put my arm around her. I'm not entirely sure, but it was just a really amazing moment. I never really would have thought that, 6 years from now, me and her would have been engaged. So it's a pretty amazing feeling to think, far back that excuse me, that you're with somebody and you never really thought to yourself that you're gonna get this far with them. So, well, then again, I did propose to her two times beforehand. First time was very stupid. It was pretty much, I was nervous because I thought she'd probably leave me when she started college. Never did. And I don't remember what the second time was, but didn't happen. I think I was just, I don't know. I don't remember. I know I did a second time. I just can't remember. But the third time was definitely where I felt like I was ready to be engaged. So I went for it. But anyways, now the last bit I will tell you guys is basically how our first kiss went. And you know, I'm not gonna get into any details about that, but the first time during the movie, or I think it was after the movie. No, it was during the movie. She looked at me, and I know she's gonna hate me for saying it, but and to be honest, I was planning to tell you guys this anyways, because there's another video I want to talk to you guys about. But she looked at me and goes, "Can I have my kiss now?" So I've never kissed. I technically kissed a girl once. It was like a quick peck, but I've never actually kissed a girl like for longer than 1 millisecond. So I was so nervous. I didn't kiss her though. I didn't kiss her until the second day I saw her. And she asked it again. And she said the same thing, "Can I have my kiss now?" So I kissed her, and yeah. And I kissed her. I actually the first time me and her kissed was actually on the bench in front of our high school. If you guys can tell, I might be blushing right now, but it's just rethinking about those moments really definitely makes my agitated day seem a little better, or night, technically. So yeah, that's pretty much how I met her. It was, you know, first saw her on the stage. We got to know each other We got to know each other through MySpace, and we didn't start going out until October 3rd, 2009. And the first movie we ever saw, or our date, was Surrogates. And our first kiss was the second day me and her saw each other after October 3rd. So, yeah. Yeah, October 3rd is actually when we saw this, by the way, just in case, because we were both. I actually remember this too. Me and her were both like, "So, no, actually, I asked her. I was like, "So, are we together? Are we going out now?" And we were both like, "Yeah, I think so." So, yeah. I just wanted to share that with you guys, pretty much a little bit of history involving my relationship with my fiance. I seriously feel like one of the luckiest guys in the world for meeting her. And to be honest, with how pretty much guys see her, you know, it feels like I snagged a trophy. You know, it just feels like I pretty much got the lottery. And I'm still riding that train on, you know, that lottery, which sounds dirty, but I'm not meaning it in a dirty way. So, yeah, I just wanted to share that with you guys. And I have another story for you in the next video after I strangle that cat.